وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to be starting a new silsila, a new series, inshallah ta'ala. And in this series, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, I want to, inshallah ta'ala, bi-mashi'atillahi, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and aid, I want to speak about how iman can affect a person's life and how iman changed the lives of great people. I also want to speak about the things that cause the iman to increase and decrease. So I've divided my lecture into three, inshallah ta'ala. In today's episode, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, is an introduction. In this introduction, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about the benefits that a person receives from iman. What benefit do I get if I come with iman? In this world and in the hereafter. So in today's introduction, that's what I'm going to talk about. I'm also going to speak about, the second thing I'm going to speak about in the introduction is there are many people who claim iman, who say, I'm a mu'min, I'm a believer. Iman, to claim it is something, and to be a believer and a mu'min is something else. Claiming is the easiest thing that a person can do. So I'm going to speak about the true believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm also going to speak about the hypocrites who claim iman but are really not mu'mineen. They are far from being believers. That is what I'm going to discuss and I'm going to cover in today's introduction, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Let me, inshallah ta'ala, start with mentioning the benefits that are in iman. And these tamarat, these benefits that are in iman, are going to be benefits in this world and benefits in the hereafter. The first, inshallah ta'ala, is the person who comes with iman, who has iman, that individual or that person, they are going to receive al-amnu wal-amanu. They're going to receive safety. And they are going to receive, by their iman that they've come with, distance from harm or any problems. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, this is the first one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who've come with iman, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ, and they do not clothe their iman with shirk. Because the word dhulm in here means shirk. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained it, when the Sahabas asked him, and they said, O Messenger of Allah, أَيُّنَا لَمْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ, which from amongst us has not oppressed himself? And then the Prophet said, no, the dhulm in this ayah is the same as the dhulm in Surah Al-Luqman. He said, أَلَمْ تَسْمَعُوا, did you not hear the statement of Luqman al-Hakim? What did Luqman say? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, that Luqman said, وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Shirk is the greatest form of oppression. So, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ, here means shirk. So the person who comes with iman and their iman is not clothed with shirk, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ. Allah says, those people are going to receive amn, safety. وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ, and they are the guided ones. So al-imanu wal-hidayah, safety and guidance are for the people of iman, the mu'min. Iman, according to Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, is qawlun, a speech. Qawlun ala al-lisan, qawlu fil-lisan. It's a qawlun, it's speech that is uttered and it's mentioned on the tongue, and it's speech on the tongue. It is also amalun. It is amalun, actions, على الجوارح, on the limbs. And it is also iman, يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية. It increases and it decreases. Iman is قول and عمل. It is the speech of the heart, and it is also the speech of the tongue. It is also the action of the heart, and it is also the actions of the limbs, those four. And it increases and it decreases. It increases in the obedience of Allah, and it decreases in the obedience of shaitan. It increases in the obedience of Allah, and it decreases in the obedience of shaitan. So these people, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, these who believed, Allah is mentioning here, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ, is referring to a people who stated the iman on their tongue, and they believed it in their hearts, and it manifested on their limbs. The second benefit that a person will receive, the second benefit that you see in al-iman, is al-hayatu al-tayyibah. You're going to live a good life. Al-hayatu al-tayyibah. وَطُمَأْنِينَةُ الْقُلُوبِ, and the tranquility of the hearts comes from it. And this is not for, وَلَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا لِأَهْلِ الْإِيمَانِ. Al-hayatu al-tayyibah, وَطُمَأْنِينَةُ الْقُلُوبِ, the good life and the tranquility of the heart is only for the believers. Those are the ones who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, they're going to receive it. The good life, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, any man or woman who comes with righteous action, a person does righteous action, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ, but with the condition that person is a believer, فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً, Allah is going to give you a good life. The good life is connected to your iman. وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is going to reward you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the best that you used to do. Pay attention here. Iman is the key to a good life. If you're trying to attain a good life, if you're trying to achieve a happy life, a prosperous life, if that's what you're looking for, and you're not looking for it through iman, then you're looking for it in the wrong places, and you will never find it. Happiness is in al-imanu billah, believing in Allah. وَلِذَلِكَ, that's why we say al-hayatu al-tayyibah وَطُمَأْنِينَةُ الْقُلُوبِ لَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا لِأَهْلِ الْإِيمَانِ. Memorize that, always remember that. A good life and the tranquility of the heart is only for the believers. I've mentioned the evidence for a good life. What about the evidences for the tranquility of the heart? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُوا الْقُلُوبُ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُوا الْقُلُوبُ. This ayah clearly shows us and tells us that those who believe, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُوا, the ones who believe, who've come with iman, they're the ones who Allah is going to give them tranquility of the heart. يعني they are going to receive tranquility, طمأنينة. That's where they're going to receive it. ولذلك بعض السلف, this story, this statement actually was mentioned by two imams من أئمة السلف. It was mentioned that Ibrahim ibn Adham and Abu Yusuf, they both went out with each other one day. And when they went to the ocean, and they both had two pieces of bread. Abu Yusuf and Ibrahim ibn Adham were dipping their breads into the ocean, into the sea. And they didn't have soup. They didn't have anything else to eat with it. They just have two dry breads. And they both started to take the breads and started to dip it into the ocean, into the sea, so when it becomes soft, so they can chew it and they can eat it. They said to each other, Ibrahim ibn Adham said to Abu Yusuf, he said to him, لو علم الملوك وأبناء الملوك ما نحن فيه من النعيم والسرور لَجَالَدُونَ عَلَيْهِ بِالسُّيُوفِ. He said, لَوْ عَلِمَ الْمُلُوكِ, if the kings and the children of the kings were to know the happiness that we have, the tranquility that we have, the joy that we have, if they knew that, the bliss and the blessings of Allah that we have, the na'im, the surur, the happiness and the blessings of Allah that we have, if they knew it, the kings and the children of the kings, what would they do? They would come out with their swords and they would try to take that away from us. They would try to take away from us the happiness and the joy and the comfort and the goodness that we have. I'm asking you all a question, every one of you who's watching and listening. We have these two imams, they don't have anything. They have no wealth, they have no money. They are dipping their breads into the ocean, into the sea. And what are they doing? They don't have meat to eat with it. With that said, they believe that they have happiness. They believe that they have joy. And that is true, they do have it. But the happiness that they're referring to, and the joy that they're referring to, and the blessing that they're referring to, is al-Iman billah. That is a happiness that nothing can buy. ولذلك الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية, he said, إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةِ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. Ibn Taymiyyah said that in this dunya, there is a jannah. If you do not enter the jannah of this dunya, you will not enter the jannah of the hereafter. And Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentioned the jannah of this dunya. What is it, brothers and sisters? It is al-imanu billah. It is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is jannah in this world. How is it a jannah in this world? Because it's what brings about al-hayatu tayyibah wa tuma'ni'natu al-qulub. It is what brings about a good life. It is what brings about the tranquility of the hearts. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentioned in those two verses that I gave, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. الآية أن الله تبارك وتعالى يسأل الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم لذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. الآية. The third benefit that the believers receive and they have when they come with الإيمان, الإيمان بالله, is الشيطان ليس له سلطان على أهل الإيمان. Shaytan has no strength and no power over them. The people of Iman, Shaytan has no power over them. The true believers, Shaytan has no power over them. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ لَهُ سُلْطَانٌ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ إِنَّمَا سُلْطَانُهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَتَوَلَّوْنَهُ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِهِ مُشْرِكُونَ. Shaytan, he has no power over the believers. إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ لَهُ سُلْطَانٌ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. The ones who are believers of Allah and the ones who rely on Allah alone, he has no power over those people. إِنَّمَا سُلْطَانُهُ, the ones he has power over, the people he controls, the people he can subjugate, are who? عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَتَوَلَّوْنَهُ, the ones that take shaytan as their ally. Those are the ones he's got control over. Those are the ones who you tend to see every now and then struggling and crying over their desires and the lack of ability to overcome their addiction. Those are the people he has control over. As for the mu'min al-sadiq, the truthful believer, he has no power over them. If he comes to that believer and tries to misguide him, all that believer does is say, "A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim." He has the strength and the iman. The fourth benefit that is in al-iman billah, the benefit that you get from believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters, is Allah azza wa jalla yatawalla difa' an ahli al-iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who defends the believers. The believers are defended by Allah. Allah protects them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He takes care of them. They are under himayatullahi, Allah's protection. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah defends the believers. He didn't say he defends the non-Muslims. He said, I defend the believers. That's the characteristics he mentioned. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Allah mentions ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. That the allies of Allah, who are the allies of Allah? الذين آمنوا, those who've come with Iman. And they've also come with what? At-taqwa. The people who came with Al-Iman and At-taqwa, they're the allies of Allah, awliya of Allah. And Allah mentions to us what? That there's no fear, there's nothing they need to be scared of. يعني, why are you scared? Allah is protecting you. لهم معقبات من بين يدي ومن خلفي يحفظونه من أمر الله. You have, you're protected from the front and you're protected from the back. You're protected from all directions. No one can harm you. No one can cause you harm. Rather, anyone who tries to harm you, because you're the awliya of Allah, anyone who tries to harm you, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will be in direct war with that person. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith al-Qudusi, مَنْ عَادَى لِوَلِيًّا فَقَدْ أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. Anyone who shows enmity and hate towards my allies, that person is in direct war with Allah. I ask you guys a rhetorical question that doesn't even need anyone to answer it because it's obvious and it's well known. Who would win in a battle between Allah and the creation? Who's going to win, the creator or the created? Who's going to win? The creator is going to win, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the believers, Ahlul Iman, the people who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have the true Iman that is needed from them, Allah will defend them. And if people slander you, people criticize you, even if people plot and plan against you, because you're a true mu'min, Allah is going to protect you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are under the ayah, you fall under the ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. You also fall under the ayah, أَلَا إِنَّ أُولِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. You also fall under the hadith al-Qudusi, مَنْ عَادَى لِوَلِيًّا فَقَدْ أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. The fifth benefit that you get from believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ajrul azim. You're going to get a lot of reward in believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're also going to get wal-bushra yawm al-qiyamah. You're going to receive glad tidings the day of judgment. And that is specifically ahli al-iman, only for the believers. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah is going to give to the believers a lot of reward. Specific for the believers. They're going to receive what? They're going to receive al-ajru al-azim, great reward. وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah is going to give to the believers, no one else. What is he going to give them? Allah is going to give them what? أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا, great reward. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِأَنَّ لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فَضْلًا كَبِيرًا. Give glad tidings to the believers that the day of judgment, they are going to receive what? They are going to receive fadlan kabiran, great virtue from their Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Great reward, glad tidings, great reward. All of that is for the believers, yawm al-qiyamah. Look at the benefits that you get in this world. Look at what you get the day of judgment. In this world, you're going to live a good life. In this world, you're going to find tranquility. You know, and the day of judgment, nothing to worry about. Don't be scared. Don't be concerned. Don't feel sad. You're reassured that your place is going to be Jannah. And what is better than Jannah? The sixth benefit in coming with al-Iman billahi subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ukhuwatu sadiqah, true brotherhood and true sisterhood. And al-ittihad, to be united, wal-i'tisam. All of that comes what? It comes fi dhillil iman, under the shade of al-iman. Under this term, al-iman, people of different countries and people of different ethnicities and background, people of different colors, people of different tribes, all of them become brothers and sisters. They become what? Brothers and sisters. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa, that the believers are brothers. They are sisters. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, الْمُسْلِمُ أَخُ الْمُسْلِمِ. The Prophet also said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الْمُؤْمِنُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ كَالْبُنْيَانِ يَشُدُّ بَعْضُهُ بَعْضًا. The Prophet also said, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ جَسَدٍ وَاحِدٍ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عُضْوٌ تَدَاعَى سَائِرَ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهْرِ وَالْحُمَى. The Prophet also said, alayhi salatu wasalam, al-mu'minu lil-mu'mini kal-bunyan yashuddu ba'duhu ba'da. The believers, that's what they are towards each other. They are one body. They are like a building cemented together. يَشُدُّ بَعْضُهُ بَعْضًا, they strengthen one another. They are to each other, the believers, that if one person is suffering, or one person is going through hardship, or one group of people are suffering, the whole entire ummah feel the pain of those people because they've become like one body. الْمُؤْمِنُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ كَالْبُنْيَانِ أَمَّا مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادُّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ جَسَدٍ وَاحِدٍ. You're like one body, one body. That if your finger today was hurting you and you wanted to go to sleep, you can't. Your eyes cannot sleep because of the finger. That's the believer, the way they are towards each other. They feel each other's pain. These six that I just mentioned are the six benefits that you receive if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That does not mean that these are the only six that you get. There are many more, but I only mentioned some. The second thing that I wanted to speak about in this introduction is Iman is claimed by many people. There are many people who come and say that I'm a believer. I believe in Allah. I'm a mu'min. What I want to say to you, my beloved brothers and sisters, is the statement Hassan al-Basri said. He said, ليس الإيمان بالتحلي ولا بالتمني ولكنه ما وقر في القلب وصدقته العمل. Imam Hassan al-Basri, he said, Iman is not just a tamanni, wishful thinking. And Iman is not something you beautify yourself with and you dress, clothe yourself and no, Iman is something that settles in the heart. And it's then something that shows on your limbs. It manifests on your limbs. It goes into your heart and then it shows on your limbs. It's not just, oh, it's in my heart. I've got a good heart. No, it goes into your heart and then it shows on your limbs. That's the truth. The woman that's not wearing hijab, the man who's shaving his beard, these people lack Iman. There is a deficiency in your Iman. Your Iman is reduced. The Iman is branches. الإيمان بضع وسبعون شعبة علىها قول لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. Iman is branches. From the branches of al-Iman is to cover yourself and conceal yourself, my beloved brothers and sisters. Understand, my beloved sisters, to conceal yourself and cover yourself and wear the hijab is a branch from the branches of al-Iman. And so if you do not cover yourself properly and the way that the Sharia legislated, you are missing a branch of al-Iman. Your Iman is reduced and it distances you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same with the brother who shaves. That individual's Iman is reduced. And it is reduced in accordance to whichever disobedience that you come with. So Iman, as I mentioned, is not a claim. It's not a da'awa. But the truth is, a da'awa ma lam tuqima bi bayinatin abna'uha di'ya. The claims that we come with, we have to bring evidences for it. We have to back up our claims and our statements. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. There are people, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. There are people who claim that they believe in Allah, that they believe in the Day of Judgment, they believe in the angels, they claim they believe in the, they are claiming it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does he say? وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. These people are not believers. They are not believers. However much they scream, I'm a believer, I'm a believer. However much he tries to hang around with the believers, he's a munafiq, ma'lum al-nifaq. He's a hypocrite known for his hypocrisy. Iman is not just a claim. So here, inshallah ta'ala, in the second part of my introduction, I want to speak about two situations. Two examples that distinguish the munafiq from the mu'min. Al-mu'min al-sadiq, the truthful believer, and the hypocrite, what is it that distinguishes them? Wallahi, when we claimed Iman, and we said we are believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tested us to know which of those two groups we're going to be from. That's why Allah said in the ayah, حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَنْ يُتْرَكُوا أَنْ يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَا يَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah says, did the people actually think that when they say, I'm a believer and I've come with Iman, did they really think that Allah is going to let them go and just take your claim for it? No. When you say, I'm a believer, okay, you're going to be tested. That statement of yours, which is, I am a believer, will be put to the test. For what? If you're truthful or if you're a liar. If you're truthful, then you are a mu'min. And if you're a liar, then you're a munafiq. You're a munafiq because you're claiming iman, but you don't really have it. You're a hypocrite. You're a hypocrite. So let's, inshallah ta'ala, see the signs to distinguish two situations I'm going to bring that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that distinguishes. It is the haddul fasil, is mafraq al-turuq between the munafiq and the mu'min. The first one is the believer when he is called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, Allah and His Messenger have said this in this issue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala judged it in this way. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger have said. This is the qada min indillahi. This is the judgment of Allah and His Messenger. The believer, what does he do and what does the hypocrite do? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, the statement of the believers, the mu'minin, إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, if they are called to Allah and His Messenger. There's an issue that's outstanding. The believer has a conflict with another believer. There is a conflict between two believers. Both of the believers are told Allah and His Messenger have a judgment in this issue. Both of the believers, because they love Allah, because they love the Messenger. What do they say? سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We hear what Allah says. We obey what Allah and His Messenger say. We hear and we obey Allah and His Messenger. What does Allah say in this issue? I hear and I obey. The other one says, what did Allah say in this issue and His Messenger? I hear and I obey. Because of their iman, they listen and they obey what Allah says. That's why Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He mentioned in the ayah that the people who do not accept the judgment of Allah and His Messenger are not believers. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. That they are not true believers. They are not true believers. The people who, when you tell them Allah and His Messenger say, and they don't accept it, they don't surrender. The minute you say to them, Allah and His Messenger say, they say, you know what, get out of here. Are you truly going to just mention these verses like that to me? Whatever you say to them, Allah and His Messenger say, they always have an excuse. They have an argument. Their hawa and their desires is what governs them. That's not what the believers are like. My beloved brothers and sisters, the mu'min is not like that. The mu'min, what did Allah mention about them? سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. I hear and I obey. Whether it goes according to my nafs or whether it doesn't, I hear and I obey. Let's look at the munafiqin. How are they like when Allah and His Messenger are mentioned? So you and I can know where we stand with the Quran and the Sunnah. Where do we stand? Are we the munafiqin or are we the believers? This is when we should be scared and worried. All of us should be scared. All of us. This is where we get scared. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He said, وَإِن يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِم مَّرَضٌ أَمِ ارْتَابُوا أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَن يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He said, وَيَقُولُونَ, they say, the munafiqeen, آمنا بالله وبالرسول وأطعنا. We believe in Allah and His Messenger. And we obey them. They say it like that. ثم يتولى فريق منهم من بعد ذلك. And after that, when the judgment of Allah is passed in the issue, they turn their backs. Allah then says, وما أولئك بالمؤمنين. Those are not believers. Those are not believers. وإذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم. When they are called to Allah and His Messenger, When the sister is told, this is what Allah said about the hijab. When the brother is told, this is what Allah said about the beard. This is what Allah said about the salah. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this particular situation. What does the munafiq say? وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. A group of them turn away. They turn their back. They don't listen. They don't adhere. They don't want to see what Allah and His Messenger say in this situation. Allah says, وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. There's sickness in their hearts. They are sick people. These are sick people. They're not healthy people. They are a sick group of people who choose to disobey Allah and His Messenger. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالُوا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ رَأَيْتَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يَصُدُّونَ عَنْكَ صُدُودًا. When they are called to Allah and His Messenger, the Quran and the Sunnah, they're told about it. Allah says, رَأَيْتَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يَصُدُّونَ عَنْكَ صُدُودًا. You see that the munafiq, he turns his back and he's running away. He doesn't want to hear all of that. To him, we're in the 21st century, brother. Wake up, get your head out of the sand. This is a statement you hear from them. Akhi, are you truly just going to mumble those same ayats? Akhi, we used to hear this in the 90s, man. Get over that, man. Life has changed. Keep up with the world. Be progressed. Are you really that dim-witted? They insult you. They belittle you. Like in believers, hold on to your book. Hold on to the sunnah. Wallahi, they're going to know one day. One day they're going to know that the path that they're treading on, the path that they are taking, wallahi, they're harming no one except themselves. They are going to destroy themselves. Wallahi, many of them are living upon depression and stress and sadness. Many of them are dwelling over harm and problems. That's the truth of their life. They are missing the tumanina, the tranquility that we're talking about. The munafiq, wallahi, doesn't find joy. The second situation that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us about the munafiq and the believer is when they are in the battlefield. When the jihad and the battlefield is happening, the believers, they're steadfast. They don't run. They believe in Allah. And Allah mentioned it, وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. Look at the believers when they saw the army. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. This is what Allah and His Messenger promised us. This is the promise that was told to us by Allah and His Messenger. That's what they say, the believers. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. Allah and His Messenger have told the truth. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. Iman has increased for them and submission. They just submit, submit, submit. That's the believers. What about the munafiqeen? وَإِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. وَإِذْ قَالَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَا أَهْلَ يَثْرِبَ لَا مُقَامَ لَكُمْ فَارْجِعُوا. وَيَسْتَأْذِنُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ النَّبِيَّ يَقُولُونَ إِنَّ بُيُوتَنَا عَوْرَةٌ وَمَا هِيَ بِعَوْرَةٍ إِن يُرِيدُونَ إِلَّا فِرَارًا. يعني the munafiqs is the opposite to the believers. He says, Allah and His Messenger lied to us. Is this what they promised us? This is nothing but deception. يعني, and does not submit. All he wants is to run away from the battle. The munafiq and the believers are never the same. And I've mentioned enough for you to comprehend, my beloved brothers and sisters. I've mentioned enough for you to take a heed, to take on board. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.